is the one which they implemented better than passing. Also, the person who made that plan, the chief government planner then, that is sort of John Kara. You know, so origin Mukurane, but his parents moved to Wera. So he was the one who took the plan to Korea, and then Korea now is the donor. So the point is that the economic growth being linked to well-being of people was disconnected. You know, this man here, Paul Collier, he was the chief economist of the World Bank. He is now a professor in Oxford. This man, when I was director general, Sam, you know him, he wrote a long article in the recent newspaper how the Minister of Health was a bottomless pit. But I met him in a meeting in Germany about 2 years ago. He's a different man now. He's written a book called The Future of Capitalism. You go to bookshops in Kampala, you'll get that, you'll read it. And basically the message is that more and the basically said in the meeting in Germany that for the last 40 years they taught wrong economics. They taught people how to make profit. Make profit, make profit, make profit. If you have no profit, you have failed. But they didn't teach them what to do with profit. So fewer and fewer people are getting richer and richer. So that maybe like 20 years ago, the 50 richest people were so and so, but now the 20 richest people, but they not talk about linking economic growth to well-being of people. But that now is what they are trying to change. And we have that challenge of the demographic need. So these are important foundations for what we want. So I read the strategic plan, right honorable Prime Minister. I read your plan, and here is a quotation from it. The ITESO can rally behind their culture as a driver for sustainable development. In this endeavor, they can be supported by other players in the region, like faith-based civil society. We are now civil society. And other actors. So we are supporting you, sir, by coming here. So let's now talk about health. My colleagues here have seen these slides before, and they use them also in various places. But these are very important concepts. I'll be very brief about them. We are all health people. And these are definitions of health from the Constitution of WHO, Universal Declaration of Human Rights. It is about well-being. It's not about the absence of disease. It's also the Declaration on Human Rights. Even talks about living conditions, you know, food, housing, clothing, and so on. Medical care is just mentioned in the list. So it is beyond absence of disease. It's about well-being, feeling well, having your basic needs met. That is what the definition of health is. And this is Alma Mater, Health Work for All. It basically tells us the people have the right as well as the duty to participate one by one and collectively in planning and implementation of their health care. That is why we are here. We are the people. We have come here today to see how we, the people of the Teso, of the Ateke group, are going to do this as a right as well as a duty. It's not a choice that we have. I will talk later about our duty to other people. So, it's what is called social determinants of health. Those are those things which indirectly affect the health of the people. We need to be aware of them. But certainly, a key one is governance of communities. Governance, 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 governance. Everything revolves about around leadership and governance. And we will come back to that. This is something which has been referred to in my days as Director General. I recorded that speech, that statement. Health is made at home, and only repaired in health facilities when it breaks down. Be clean, eat well, do not share accommodation with animals. This is the message from the Director General of Health Services. Do you remember?
Oh, yes.
So, and that is real. Health is made in the way people live every day. And this is what we want to change through this approach. And we are all born healthy. Health is in bone. About 6% of people are born with congenital malformation, this one, the other one, but the rest of us are born. And our bodies, we have all learned this, our videos. This guy, Claude, you have all read this in your videos. Maintaining the internal environment. So, your body tells you, rest, you are tired. Go to sleep, you are young. You are thirsty, you take some water. So if we obey our bodies, you know, we can remain healthy without needing health care for a long, long time from. So that is what we want to change. Inborn health from womb to tomb. But this calls for a partnership between individual, the health system, and the government. It calls for this partnership. And people, of course, value their health. This was a study which was done here in Uganda, 2002. They were asking rural people, so what is your biggest problem? Most people were saying it is poor health and diseases. Then the question is flipped around, so, oh, sorry that you are poor. What is it that happened to you now that you are poor? So people value their health, but we need to help them to convert their value for health into the right behavior. And it is possible. This is the message about good health at low cost. This is what you need. Health as a goal, a societal goal. This is national, if we are talking about the country, but community, as a community goal, a social goal for the community, integrated into the governance. And health promotion should not be left behind because you are focusing on healing sick people. Okay? You need a correct balance. And it becomes an integrated people-centered primary health care. And those are the countries who have done it. Thailand, Kerala State, even Ethiopia. Sometimes I remove Rwanda when I speak in some places. Some people don't like to hear that. And so, this is about outcome now. No. Before you can do something, you need to feel that it is your responsibility. You need to own it. And it needs to come from you, from inside you. It should not be forced. So it must become something we own. We must convert our people to own it. And this again is where we come in as experts, highly educated people. If this group cannot address Teso's problem, it's very unlikely that there is another group with capacity like we have here.